The Future Combat Air System, or FCAS, being developed by Germany, France and Spain, is a competing and concurrent effort of the same name being undertaken by the UK, Italy and Sweden. Both officially launched at about the same time in the mid-2010s, the Euro FCAS and the UK-led FCAS concern the building of a system of systems for the future air battle space. At the heart of both FCASs is an optionally piloted aircraft, which for the Euro FCAS is known as the New Generation Fighter, or NGF, and for the UK-led FCAS as the Tempest. These optionally piloted aircraft are to be supported by uncrewed loyal wingmen, known as remote carriers or mosquitoes, respectively. These combinations of combat aircraft and UAVs are then networked together by means of a combat cloud. This is known as the Next Generation Weapon System, or NGWS, for the Franco-German-Spanish effort, while there is no formal name for the UK-led effort. For both the European and the UK-led efforts, this core FCAS will be expanded to include all other legacy and future assets operating in the air battle space. As the core element of both FCASs, the optionally piloted combat aircraft are the most clearly defined elements of the projects, in terms of their intended roles, technologies and timelines. For both the NGF and Tempest, full-scale mock-ups have been showcased that are somewhat conventional in nature, resembling current fifth-generation types, with the angular fuselages, canted tails and internal weapons bays required for stealth. Both are twin-engine types, with conventional flight control surfaces, conventionally located cockpits and other facets familiar to current designs. However, while both projects have showcased full-scale mock-ups of their optionally piloted fighters, these are understood to be representations as to what the final products may look like, as opposed to what the final designs themselves will actually be. For the Euro FCAS, the parties have declared a land and or carrier-based platform, while the Tempest will be a purely land-based affair. Both platforms will perform missions that broadly mirror those already conducted by today's combat aircraft. However, one additional capability will be the need to be a control ship for the uncrewed or wingmen. The uncrewed wingmen could be launched from the fighter itself, or from transport aircraft serving as motherships, or from ground bases, or from ships such as aircraft carriers. They would serve as force multipliers, carrying and releasing weapons in their own right, or being weapons themselves, or being decoys. Interestingly, while the law wingmen have been touted in a support role to the optionally piloted fighter, the UK recently raised the possibility of a role reversal, with this Mosquito Law Wingman claiming primacy over the Tempest. Earlier in 2021, Minister of State for Defence, Jeremy Quinn, suggested that the Mosquito itself may become the primary element of FCAS when he noted that uncrewed aircraft are set to replace the RAF's Eurofighter Typhoons in the air-to-air role from the mid-2030s. In terms of the technologies, both aircraft will build on upgrades and other developments planned for the current generation of Eurofighter and Rafale platforms. Interestingly, Sweden has said that it wants to use the FCAS technology to enhance its Gripen, but not if it intends to use Gripen upgrades to help drive Tempest development. Both platforms will utilize advanced autonomy, cyber capabilities, mass data, radar developments in the field of passive and cognitive sensors, hypersonic and laser weapons, unmanned and swarming technologies, quantum computing, advanced robotics, access to space, augmented reality, advanced hypersonic propulsion technologies, although it should be noted that the platforms themselves will not be hypersonic, exotic composites, 3D printing, low observable technologies, data fusion for command and control, artificial intelligence, and upgradable software.